What's happening, everyone? It's the 4th of September 2021. I'm NoHow92 and today I'm gonna play Splinterlands, a blockchain NFT game. Splinterlands is one of my favorite, if not my favorite, blockchain game. It's built upon Hive blockchain and today I'm gonna try to complete my life quest. Let's check out the details. Chaos seems to be routing all across Splinterlands, and yet Himeria is stable. Don't let wretches from Mother Splinters ruin the sacred and protected homeland. Form a patrol and keep undesirables out of our home. Objective: win 5 rank battles, with the Life Splinter. 2 loot chests. I'm gonna receive 2 loot chests once I complete my daily quest, because I'm currently in Silver 3, on my way to Silver 2. So, let's play. I decided to record my gameplay and open my mic because some people in my YouTube asked about tips in Splinterlands. The first tip I'm gonna give you is to always check out which splinters and cards your opponent played in his last or her last 5 games. There we can see that my opponent played the Fire Splinter. I guess he's gonna play the Fire Splinter again, or she, I'm sorry. Always check out the battle rules. And we've got a huge mana cap. Okay, gonna use the Life Splinter. I can use a ton of mana, that's very good. I mean, I can use a lot of cards. There it is, my team. Shieldbreaker is a great tank. You always need to place a good tank, a strong tank, a monster with a lot of health points and shield at the front row. And then you need to place other cards that can do damage to our opponent. Let's go. And let's see if we can win Yokuni. There it is, the Fire Splinter, as I foresaw. Nice. I think I can win this game, guys. There it is, easy peasy. The reason I won this game is because my monsters had a ton of armor and my opponent used Fire Splinter. Fire Splinter boosts my opponent monster's attack. I used armor, so melee attacks couldn't hurt me, and that's pretty much it. That's how I won this battle. The Earth Splinter, the Death Splinter and the Fire Splinter. My opponent uses a lot of splinters. Okay, non-flying monsters take 2 melee damage at the end of each round, and monsters do not have armor or do not get armor from abilities or summoner buffs. This means that my Tyrus Palladium effect is worthless. So what I'm gonna do is use another Life Splinter card, the Mother Kala. My monsters are gonna gain 1 health point. And now I need to fight with some monsters, like this one, this one. I chose these two monsters, these two cards, the Warrior of Peace, because Warrior of Peace has a lot of health points. Warrior of Peace is my tank for this game. And Luminous Eagle, because Luminous Eagle can attack from the second row thanks to its reach ability, and it's a flying type monster, so it won't get affected by this rule of combat. Non-flying monsters take 2 melee damage at the end of each round. My Luminous Eagle is safe, and I've got 3 mana left, so I'm gonna go with Enhanced Pixie. It's a flying monster. And I'm gonna add my Furious Chicken. Let's go. This is gonna be a tough game, but I think we can do it, guys. Let's see what's gonna happen. Damn, my opponent chose the water splinter. I think we can do it, guys. There it is. GG. Second win in a row. The trick is to always take a look at what your opponent used in his previous 5 games. This dude uses a ton of melee damage and monsters have the opportunity ability. Now, the opportunity ability is, there is one monster with the opportunity. Monster with the opportunity ability may attack from any position and will target the enemy monster with the lowest health. This means that we have to bait our opponent with some monsters with low health. Now I've got 38 mana cap, barrier, I'm sorry, luminous sigil. I'm gonna use my Furious Chicken as bait right here. Silver Shield Knight, Silver Shield Assassin, this combo is great. Silver Shield Knight adds one melee attack point to all my melee monsters, and Silver Shield Assassin attacks twice. And I've got 8 mana left. I think I'm gonna go the Worm has 9 mana, Warchunk has 7 mana. Let's go with Bile of the Radiant. Oh, this is not looking good, guys. This summoner has a weird effect. All friendly monsters receive the Thorns ability. This means that when I attack one of his monsters, my own monster will suffer 2 damage. There it is. Damn! I think I've lost, guys. Yep. Damn it. This Thorns ability is really annoying, but that's okay. I've won 2 games until now and I've lost only 1. Okay, 14 mana cap. All monsters have the Enrage ability. Monsters lose all abilities. It's gonna be tricky. That's really tricky, guys. I need to play it smart. So, what I'm gonna do is, it's tricky. Okay, guys, gonna use Mother Kala. My Crystal Jaguar. And my Luminous Sigil. Let's go. I don't like this team I chose, but whatever now. If it's meant to win, I'm gonna win. But I don't think that's the case. Fuck. I've lost. God damn it. Let's play more. Okay, my opponent uses a lot of heal and a lot of melee attack damage. 24 mana cap. Okay. Now, the equalizer is one of my favorite rules. Because all my monsters gain the health of the monster with the highest health on the field. This includes my opponent monsters too. So this is what I'm gonna do. Gonna use my Enhanced Defender as a tank. It's got one health point, but it's gonna skyrocket in health. Then gonna use my Luminous Sigil, classic. My Silver Shield Knight for some extra damage. Or shouldn't I use my Luminous Sigil? Maybe I shouldn't use my Luminous Sigil at this game, guys. I could use, instead of my Luminous Sigil, I could use a Parasite Growth. It's slow, but it's good. A Light Elemental for sure. I need some magic damage. Always add some magic damage to your team. And I think I'm also gonna use my Feral Spirit and then my pick here. My opponent has quite a strong team. Nice. The big damage is out of the way. I think I'm gonna win this one, my friends. Yep. GG. Very nice. The equalizer did wonders. 70 points. I'm still ahead from where I started, I'm sorry, around 50 to 60 points. All ranged and magic attack monsters have the snipe ability. My opponent uses the Earth Splinter a lot with this, the Mylor crawling summoner. So what I'm gonna do is, I don't know if that's a good move from my side, but I'm gonna risk it. Yeah, there it is. Now, magic attacks, only melee attacks activate this summoner's boost. How can I call this? Oh my god, my brain lagged. Anyway, check this out. When I attack with magic attack, oh, damn. Okay. Nice. Okay, GG. As you can see, magic attacks don't activate this summoner's effect. So I was able to win. One more win, and I'm gonna claim today's reward. The other day I claimed like 745 dark energy crystals. That's around $5 or $6. There it is, my opponent is using the Earth Splinter a lot. Legendary monsters may not be used in battle, and reverse speed monsters with the lowest speed attack first and have the highest chance of evading attacks. Mana cap 40. So we need some slow monsters right now. This one is ideal. Now, let's check out which monsters have low attack speed. I'm gonna use my Luminous Eagle Line, sorry, anyways. Gonna add this one, the Sandworm. It's kinda tricky right now. Gonna add some heal. I've got 6 mana left. Let's add the Evangelist, and I think we're good to go. Come on, my friend. Oh. The Divine Sealed Summoner. This means that when I attack one of these monsters, they won't suffer any damage. There it is. Check this out. No damage at all. Okay. I think that's my game, guys. Bye bye. G to the fucking G. That's how you do it. Time to claim my reward. A gold foil card. Was gonna be awesome, or a legendary gold foil, or just a legendary. But nope, it's not gonna happen. 81 dark energy crystals are not bad though, that's like 70 cents. I had some fun, earned some money, some dark energy crystals, and of course tried to explain you a few things about Splinterlands. That's by any means, that's not by any means a tutorial, but I hope you learned something from my video, and leave a comment below if you want me to keep recording those videos, and comment on my moves and gameplay. Much love to everyone. Thank you for your support, and hustle them, crypto hard yo. Peace.